So hi everyone, once again you are most welcome on my YouTube channel The Passion of Learning English. So today I am going to teach you the types of the sentences with examples. So now let's know what kind of the sentences and how to make it and how to identify it. So now generally there are seven types of the sentences. First is affirmative sentences, which Hindi is sakaratmak vakya. This is the first part. Now second in the sentence, that is the negative sentence, which Hindi is nakaratmak vakya. Now third is interrogative sentences, which is prashnavachak vakya. Now fourth is question types of the words. It is also the part of the interrogative, but in this sentence we use question word for the reasons, for the purpose, for the time, for the place, and which we are going to learn with examples. Now fifth is, that is imperative sentences. Imperative sentences Hindi adesh atmak and agya suchak vakya. You can also call it adesh atmak also and agya suchak vakya also, in which we talk about suggestion, order and permission. So it is called imperative sentences. Now sixth is, that is exclamatory sentences, which Hindi is Bishmay Bodhak Vakya. The sentence which express feeling, happiness, sorrow, applause. So that is called exclamatory sentences. And also we will learn and we will make the sentences related to the exclamatory sentences. Now seven, that is the last, optative sentences, which Hindi is here Ichha Suchak Vakya. So now this sentence is also expressed like a hope, desire, strong determinations and so many things comes in it. So that is called optative sentences. Now we are going to know the sentences by making the examples. Now let's see some examples. So now we are going to know the first part, that is the affirmative sentence. Affirmative sentence, which is talking about simply, which is talking about with positivity, means in the sentence there is a positivity. So there are some examples for you, like वह एक ईमानदार अधिकारी है. वह एक ईमानदार अधिकारी है. So this sentence is in positive, because in this sentence there is no any question, we are not asking any question, and also we are not doing any kinds of the rejection. So now let's translate. वह एक ईमानदार अधिकारी है. सो ही इज एन ईमानदार ऑनेस्ट अधिकारी ऑफिसर. सो ही इज एन ऑनेस्ट ऑफिसर. नाउ सेकंड सेंटेंस, दिस इज ऑल्सो अफर्मेटिव सेंटेंस. इन दिस सेंटेंस दे नो एनी क्वेश्चन, वी आर नॉट डूइंग एनी क्वेश्चन, एंड ऑल्सो दे नो एनी काइंड ऑफ द रिजेक्शन. So these kind of the sentences are affirmative. So आपके पास कुछ किताबें हैं. So this is our positive sentence, or you can call it affirmative sentences. So you have some books. So now see the third sentence. हम इस काम को कर सकते हैं. So in this sentence we are not asking any questions, and also we are not doing any kinds of the rejections. So the sentence which is not coming in the form of the rejection, and which is not coming in the form of interrogation, so that is called affirmative sentence. So now let's translate. we can do is kaam ko this work. So this is affirmative sentence. Now see the negative sentences. Now the second part, that is the negative sentences. So it is second type of sentence which will be in the form of the negative. Negative means the sentence नहीं, ना और मत. If these kind of the words are coming in the sentences, so these sentences are called negative sentence. नाउ लेट्स सी सम एग्जांपल्स. आप क्लास में उपस्थित नहीं है. सो इन दिस सेंटेंस नहीं वर्ड इज कमिंग. सो दिस इज द आइडेंटिटी ऑफ द सेंटेंस. नाउ सी सेकंड सेंटेंस, हम दिल्ली नहीं जा रहे. सो नहीं वर्ड इज कमिंग. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो नेगेटिव टाइप ऑफ द सेंटेंस. नाउ सी द थर्ड सेंटेंस, वह आपके साथ नहीं रहता है. सो नहीं वर्ड इज कमिंग, इट मीन्स वी आर रिजेक्टिंग एनी थिंग्स. We are rejecting any proposal, we are rejecting any purpose which are asking to us. Now let's translate these sentences. आप क्लास में उपस्थित नहीं है. So you with you helping verb and after the helping verb we take the not. So whenever you are going to make this sentence, so not words always come after helping verb, like is, am, are, was, were, shall, will, do, does. So these are the helping verbs. So always you need to understand whenever you are going to put or add not words. So you will always keep it after the helping verb. You can see in this examples, you are not upasthit, present, class mein, in the क्लास. सो यू आर नॉट प्रेजेंट इन द क्लास. सेकंड सेंटेंस, हम दिल्ली नहीं जाते. सो वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू दिल्ली. वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू दिल्ली. सो इन दिस सेंटेंस वी आर आफ्टर द हेल्पिंग वर्ब वी आर यूजिंग नॉट वर्ड. सो दिस इज, it means our sentence is in negative because not word is coming. Now see another sentence, वह आपके साथ नहीं रहता है. So he does, this is helping verb because this sentence is in present definite. He does not रहना, live आपके साथ, with you. So these all sentences are in negative sentence and these are called negative sentence. Now let's see the third part, that is the interrogative. So now we are going to learn the third part, that is interrogative sentence. Such sentence which asks a question in the sentence. So there are two types of the interrogative sentence. First, the sentence which start with helping verb, and helping verb means like is, am, are. If these words are coming in the starting, so these kind of the sentences will be called interrogative. Now the sign of interrogative, always you have to use question mark. So now the sentence which start with helping verb, that is called interrogative sentences. And the sentence second, the sentence which start with WH family or which start with question words like what, where, when, and which, how many. So these kind of the sentences are called question word or WH family. So first, the sentence which start with helping verb. So in this sentence, we have to just give the answer in yes or no, which you can see in these three sentences. Now let's see, क्या आप मेरे साथ सहमत हैं? So whenever क्या word is coming in the starting, so whenever क्या word is coming in the starting, so you will use your helping verb according to the sentences, and the helping verb which you are going to use in the sentence, those helping verb you will use. So in the sentence, helping verb are, after are subject, so are you, and then object, agree, are you, agree, and another mere saath, with me, are you agree with me, and in the last you have to use the question mark, the sign of the question, by which the sentence will be recognized that this sentence is in the question. So always after the helping verb then subject will come. Now see in this sentence, क्या वह आपकी मदद कर सकता है? सो इन दिस सेंटेंस क्या वर्ड इज कमिंग? सो हेल्पिंग वर्ब विल कम इन द स्टार्टिंग. सो क्या हेल्पिंग वर्ब कैन, आफ्टर द हेल्पिंग वर्ब देन यू विल यूज सब्जेक्ट दैट इज ही, मदद करना, हेल्प, कैन ही हेल्प आपकी यू, एंड डू नॉट मिस यूजिंग द क्वेश्चन मार्क, बिकॉज दिस इज द साइन ऑफ द इंटरोगेटिव सेंटेंस. नाउ सी द थर्ड सेंटेंस, क्या वे आप के, क्या आपके पास कुछ खाने के लिए है. सुनाओ, वी आर आस्किंग द क्वेश्चन एंड इन दिस क्वेश्चन वी हैव टू जस्ट गिव द आंसर इन यस और नो. नाउ फर्स्ट हेल्पिंग वर्ब हैव, आफ्टर हैव यू, देन कुछ, समथिंग, दिस इज द ऑब्जेक्ट, हैव यू समथिंग, एंड टू, खाने के लिए. सो दिस इज द वर्ब, सो यू विल यूज इट, एंड आफ्टर टेकिंग इट यू विल यूज क्वेश्चन मार्क. सो दिस सेंटेंस, दिस सेंटेंस आर कंप्लीट, एंड दिस काइंड ऑफ द सेंटेंसेस आर कॉल्ड इंटरोगेटिव टाइप ऑफ द सेंटेंसेस. नाउ लेट्स सी द फोर्थ पार्ट, दैट इज क्वेश्चन वर्ड्स. सो दिस इज द फोर्थ पार्ट विच इज डब्ल्यू एच फैमिली और क्वेश्चन वर्ड. यू कैन कॉल इट ऑल्सो डब्ल्यू एच फैमिली, ऑल्सो यू कैन कॉल इट क्वेश्चन वर्ड्स. सो नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट आर द क्वेश्चन वर्ड्स. क्वेश्चन वर्ड्स लाइक व्हाट, व्हाट इज यूज फॉर अ ऑब्जेक्ट, वेयर, इट्स हिंदी इज कहाँ, एंड इट इज यूज फॉर प्लेस, व्हेन, इट्स हिंदी इज कब, एंड इट इज यूज फॉर टाइम. नाउ सी नेक्स्ट हाउ, दिस इट्स हिंदी इज कैसे, एंड इट इज यूज फॉर मैनर्स. नाउ सी नेक्स्ट why, it's Hindi is kyun, and it is used for reason. Now see next, that is whose, and it is used for relation, and it's Hindi is kiska, kiski, kiske. And now last is which is used for selections. So these are the question words which are used in different types of the form and in different type of the situations. So now let's see some examples related to WH words. So now we are going to learn the fourth part of types of the sentences, that is WH family or question words. So now look at these sentences. The first sentence is here, aap jeevan mein kya banna chahte hain. So kya word is coming here for the object, because in this sentence object has not been given, therefore we are asking questions. Now let's translate these sentences into English. First, you will take question word, what. After it, you will take helping verb. So, this is the present indefinite sentence, because in the last, te hain, ta hain, ti hoon, ta hoon, if these words are coming, so these kind of the sentences are called present indefinite sentence. So, we have taken question word, after question word, helping verb, and after helping verb, we will take the subject. Subject is you. Then what do you, and when in the sentence two verb has been given, so we always choose or select the main verb. The main verb is always come in the last of the sentence, that is here chahna. So for chahna we are going to use want. What do you want, and when we are going to take second verb, so between both verb we will take or we will add two word as a preposition, because when two verbs have been given in any sentences, so we use two. Now banna like become, or also you can write here be word. Both English is same or Hindi is same. What do you want to become? Jeevan mein, in the life. So what do you want to become? In the life. Now in the last you have to use the question mark sign, because it's very important, because it indicate that this sentence is in a WH family. Now look at see the second sentence. The second sentence is here, where is kaam ko kaise karta hai. So now kaise word, this is the WH family, and kaise word is coming for asking the manner. It is asking the manner, because the subject or the someone doesn't know how to do this work. So therefore, this sentence is also in the interrogative. Now, kaise? So whenever you are making the sentence, so first you will take in the starting question word. After question word, you are going to take the helping word. And once again, this sentence is also in a present definite. So we use helping verb, do does. And when subject is he, she, it, so we use does. And when subject is I, we, they, and plural name, plural number, so we use do word. So subject is here he, so therefore we are using does word, and does it as a helping verb. So how does he karna, this is the verb, do is kaam ko, this is the object. How does he do this work? And do not miss using the question mark. Now let's see the third sentence. The third sentence, मैं ग्रामर क्यों सीखना चाहता हूँ. सो क्यों वर्ड, दिस इज द क्वेश्चन वर्ड और दिस इज द डब्ल्यू फैमिली वर्ड. सो क्यों वर्ड इज कमिंग हेयर फॉर द रीजन. इट इज आस्किंग द रीजन. सो व्हाई यू आर डूइंग दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. सो इट इज आस्किंग द क्वेश्चंस. सो नाउ फॉर क्यों वर्ड, सो द इंग्लिश ऑफ क्यों व्हाई. एंड व्हेन एवर यू आर गोइंग टू बिगिन द सेंटेंस और स्टार्ट द सेंटेंस, सो डू नॉट they no need to be more confused, or you always the question words come in the starting. So why we are taking first why, and after it according to the subject helping verb why do I, and after it if two verbs have been given, so main verb will come chahana, and after the first word then and before the second verb we will use to. Why do I want to seekhna learn? Why do I want to learn the grammar? So now this sentence is complete. Why do I want to learn the grammar? Now see the fourth sentence. The fourth sentence is here. आप यहां से कहां जा रहे हैं? So this sentence is in a present continuous. And kahan word is coming as a question words, and for the place we are asking in the sentence the name of the place, and therefore we are questioning. So now let's make first whenever you are going to make the sentence, and sentence has been given in the question and with question words, so you will use question word in the starting where, and after where helping verb. Helping verbs come according to the subject. Subject is you. So with you, we use are word. So where are you? Where are you? And after it, verb. And in the verb, we will use ing. Because in the present continuous sentence, with main verb, we use ing. Where are you going? Yahan se. So from here. Where are you going from here? And now question marks. So now these sentences are in a WH family, or you can call question words. And these kind of sentences you can make if question words are coming. So you will take the in the starting question words, after helping verb, then after helping verb subject, then verb, or after verb then objects. I hope you have understood the chapter of the WH family or question words. Now let's see in the next video. So now this is the fifth part, that is imperative sentences. Imperative sentences means which talks about suggestion, request and order. So that is called imperative sentences, and its Hindi is adeshatmak vakya. So now you are going to learn imperative sentences. So there are some basic things which are very important for you. In the imperative sentence, we do not include the subject. Subject is not used in imperative sentence. Second, we always give the command or order to the second person. So we always talk about or say about to the second person. Third, we can use the object of the subject. Like object is me, him, her, us. So these are the object of the subject, like pronouns. So be remember always, you have to take the, you have not to take the subject in, when you are going to make the sentence. Second, we always talk about, we always give the order, suggestion or request to the second person, that is the you. And subject is not taken always, its object is taken in the imperative sentence. Now the structure of making the imperative sentences, that is verb first form and object. And when we are doing, or when we are talking about the request or polite request, when we talk about request, so we use please word. But whenever we talk about polite request, so we use kindly word. So please, kindly after verb first form, then object. Okay, but if you are going to make the sentence in the negative, so you can use for negative word don't word, or also do not, do not word, and after it you will use verb first form, then object. So now let's make the sentences in imperative. First, यहां से बाहर जाओ. So we are giving order. So this is the imperative sentences. So get out यहां से, from here. Now see the second sentence, that is कृपया मेरी बात सुनिए. So we are doing the request here. So this is also the part of imperative sentence. So कृपया, please listen, please listen मेरी बात, please listen my opinion, please listen my opinion, please listen to my opinion also you can write here, please listen to my opinion. Now see next, दवाइयां समय पर लेना. सो इन दिस सेंटेंस वी आर गिविंग द एडवाइस. सो फर्स्ट टेक द वर्ब, टेक द मेडिसिंस समय पर, ऑन द टाइम. सो टेक द मेडिसिन ऑन द टाइम. नाउ सी, if imperative sentence is negative, so you will use don't or do not. उसे परेशान मत करो. So we are giving the order, but we are saying in negative form. So for negative we use do not or don't. So don't परेशान करना, disturb, don't disturb उसे, him, and also if you are talking about female, so her, for male him, or for female her. Now see next sentence, कृपया से छुए ना. So कृपया, now we can remove it, कृपया, कृपया means please, this is negative, so you will use after please word do not or don't. छूना, that is the verb. After do not you will use verb touch, और इसे it. So please do not touch it. Now दया करके दरवाजा बंद कर दें. So दया करके, for दया करके word you will use kindly. So kindly दरवाजा बंद कर दें. So kindly close the door. So these are the format of the imperative sentences. We always make these sentences in simple verb first form and object. Second, when sentence is negative form, so we can use do not, do not, and also don't. And always it start with verb first form and object. So I hope you have understood the fifth part of the sentences. Now let's see in the next part. So now we are going to learn the sixth part, that is the exclamatory sentence. What is the exclamatory sentence? The exclamatory sentence which express love, hate, anger, applause, admiration, happiness and joy. So these kind of the sentences called exclamatory sentences. Now let's see and let's see what kind of the sentences. कितना सुंदर, बधाई हो, बहुत सुंदर काम, आप कितने डरपोक हैं, काश मैं डॉक्टर होता, भगवान कितना महान है. सो दीज ऑल सेंटेंसेस आर कॉल्ड एक्सक्लेमेटरी सेंटेंसेस एंड द ऑलवेज द साइन ऑफ एक्सक्लेमेटरी सेंटेंस दैट इज यू विल ऑलवेज यूज द साइन व्हेन इन द सेंटेंस anger, happiness, joy, sorrow, these kind of the feeling or emotions are coming. So the sign of exclamatory sentence this is. Now let's make these sentences. Kitna sundar, so how beautiful, how beautiful, and the sign of exclamatory that is this. Now badhai ho, so we will use congratulation. Congratulation. Now, बहुत सुंदर काम. Very excellent work. And do not miss using the sign of exclamatory. Now. फोर सेंटेंस, भगवान कितना महान है, हाउ ग्रेट गॉड इज, हाउ ग्रेट गॉड इज. नाउ फिफ्थ सेंटेंस, आप कितने डरपोक हैं, सो हाउ टीमिड यू. Now, sixth sentence, काश मैं एक डॉक्टर होता. So, if I were a doctor, if I were a doctor. So now you can see these all sentences are expressing somewhere happiness, joy, sorrow. So that is called exclamatory sentence. Now let's see the seventh part, that is optative sentence. So now we are going to learn the seventh part, that is optative sentence. The optative sentence means the sentence which express curse, hate, love and desire. So these are the sign of optative sentences. Now we always use in the last of the sentence the sign of exclamatory. So this is the sign of exclamatory. This sign is used also in the exclamatory sentences and also optative sentences. Now let's see what kind of the sentences are in the optative. For example, Bhagwan aapki madad kare. So may God help you, and in the last you are going to use this sign. And also in Hindi. So when we are going to make the sentence in optative, so we will use may word. Okay, got it. Now second sentence, Bhagwan aapki sari ichchhaen puri kare. Bhagwan aapki sari ichchhaen puri kare. So may God complete, or also you can write fulfill, aapki sari ichchhaen, your all wishes, and in the last the sign of exclamatory. Now third sentence, Bhagwan aapko maaf kare. So first the sentence will start with may words, because most of the sentences of the optative start with may words. So may, and then may God, maaf karna, forgive, and aapko, you. May God forgive you, and the sign of exclamatory. Now last sentence, Bhagwan aap par daya kare. So may God do karna, and daya mercy and also at the place of mercy you can keep or you can write compassion upper on you, and in the last the sign of exclamatory. So these all sentences are optative sentences. I hope you have understood these all sentences, which are in many types of the way. You have understood negative, interrogative, WH family, imperative sentences, exclamatory sentences, and in the last optative sentences. So please keep on learning English and keep on watching my YouTube channel, The Passion of Learning English. So thank you so much for watching my videos.